Hello, party. This is Chris, and welcome to the final part of Devil May Cry 3 Marathon at the Institute. Finally, I can finally put this video up right now, and finally finish it after a long absence. I'm very sorry that the video was wrong. I should have read that before the marathon, but I really, really apologize for not making it to the studio. And now, yeah, this is the final part. I'm sorry for the last part not having content, because I didn't even give it to him when I uploaded. I got out of it, so. And right now is the final part of part 3, and hopefully part 4 will be coming out this weekend. Hopefully the thing will be over by the end of the month. Because I'm gonna be taking a bit break from YouTube for a little while. Maybe that. So basically speeding up this section. DMC4 and DMC5 will be the same thing, so I mean just speedrunning through things. And adding post commentary. I'm not gonna have any commentary in game. Gonna just go ahead and do it. So yeah, I'm playing this level. Me basically getting the moon and the sun crystals to line together. I think the boss fight is this lady. And yeah, I've been definitely using Quicksilver with I think when you equip Super Sparta, you'll get Quicksilver with it. So literally it helps. Me doing it. I still remember the rules of the whole challenge. I know the challenge has been a while, but yeah. By the way, Tiger will do a challenge himself, so look out for that one. And yeah, finally doing a proper video. The last one I did was Yakuza 3 about the whole stuff. And as you can see, I'm speeding through this part here. This video was recorded last month, so I think it was like last month or something like that. So it's been like a month since I recorded this video. But I don't know why I don't have time to upload it. I really still don't know how to upload the video. So here I am basically doing jump cancels with the Stinger. I'm sorry, Stinger. The Beowulf doing the jump cancel Starfalls. So yeah, it was pretty deadly and pretty strong attack from the drive. I might re-upload the next part, maybe part 2, I might just like re-upload it again. Down and re-upload it, that commentary to make it better. I might just do that, so I'm gonna get re-upload. So here we are right now. Need to beat these two balls. Need to be smashed to each other. I'm trying here to hit them both. Actually, I got it for some. I don't know how I got this one. I get the piece. Doors and I'm finding them. As you can see, I'm basically all I'm doing is just sword down on them. Yeah, I'm doing sort of down high stuff. Completely get Agnew Nuke there. Get out of that move. That move is pretty deadly and pretty. Yeah, what I'm trying to do is a double jump explosion. DTE. It's one of the best things that Dante has. It's really damaging and you get a lot of stop points, so have a lot of stop points. So I know I don't have a good quality microphone, I'm just using my headset. My headphones, and yeah, I went to the wrong turn, and I'm not using the quality microphone. It's a bit hot sometimes. Sorry for that. I just make it like a little cold, just a tiny bit cold. Although it's snowing right now, at this point, it's starting to melt, so no more snowing anymore. And here I am now fighting Lady Boss Battle. She has an alternate costume. When you use Sparta, she has kind of a jacket outfit, but I don't know why she doesn't really see. She has kind of a jacket, and I'm doing this Quicksilvering to beat her, but she dodges for some reason. Quick note, do not do any stingers or type of attacks that has full triangle. Lock on forward and triangle. It's not good. I'm trying to find where she is, Looks over and just try to beat her up and attack her. Although I know it's cheap, but Tiger's challenge said use anything, so from using it, open Tiger at all. It just says that's basically the same thing as anything, so. Not a lot of people say, well, why are you not choosing any styles? Use differences so much when you actual gameplay. Well, you gotta get that in Devil May Cry 4, okay? Okay, you freaking cry babies. So, heck, you might see actually play some stuff in DMC 4, not even super characters. Maybe. I believe that there's only one chapter I'm gonna use it. It's gonna be chapter 10. I don't want to beat Dante. I don't know because Dante is such a bitch to fight in Devil May Cry 4. I can just do that, but the rest of them I can just play. I might need some bit of training to play Devil May Cry 4. Bit of practicing, because it's been a while since I played that game. Been playing DMC 5 a lot more than 4. Yeah, I've been playing Virgil in 4 and 5, so... With Virgil, I think I don't need the Super GT. I have different skills to do, so... Yeah, I'm gonna edit the same way I edit this fast forwarding stuff and all that. Just do fast forwards and. Yeah, he's living in the apartment when I used to do this, so. Yeah. And I beat her up. I beat her, and of course, the speed. I'm basically gonna commentate throughout the entire video, so. It took a pretty long video, because I don't like talking too much. But that thing is gonna make the video more boring, but adding a bit of commentary will be kinda alright, I guess. Like, it's not that bad, but it'll be kinda good. Now, here comes chapter 17. That's where you fight that your inner demon, the doppelganger boss, basically. So I went to the wrong way, had to go to the door, and this part with the cubes. You need to jump on. You can just click slower to make it slow. I can't remember. I think I used it. But I think. I'm not 100% sure. I keep on falling and falling. Here, at least you see me fail if I do make any attempts. Yeah, it does. Because I remember I used click slower to stop time and I can jump through stuff, make stuff slower to make it easier for me on me. So as you can see, it slows down a little bit, so it makes it easier to get through parts. It's very easy actually to click slower, and I fucking literally missed. I literally just missed. I failed again. It's not that easy. I know you can see people doing this with Trickster and never at Trickster, and it's just amazing. But I'm not that professional of a level, so. Yeah, I went there and skipped the Jester fight. The Jester fights are optional. I have to fight them because you have to fight them only one time. You have to fight them all the time, by the way. So... Yeah, you have three fights. You only need to fight them once. Only mandatory fight. And it's all just different. You see, I'm using double trigger explosion. And I do Quicksilver. Although I don't have, you know... I don't know if I actually get slower. It's actually the same speed. I don't know why. I can't remember. Because I'm using because I fast forwarding was actually moving slow. And I jumping up and room. You fight these. I think you fight these new enemies. They're kind of like a super lust, I have to call them, because these guys are like they're kind of lusts, but they can just jump around like crazy. I don't know, kind of a super strong demon. I don't know how to call them. Sorry, you can call it super lust, let's just call them that. And I actually gonna make a YouTube video of me actually playing some of the levels with no upgrades at all on Dante Must Die. I thought it was like a level or two just to see how I can do it. So it's an explosion, also one of the best moves. Alright, now we are gonna we're gonna fight the doppelganger boss. I was like waiting and just remember I need to pick up some stuff. Cerberus is a really good weapon for literally destroying that thing pretty fast. It's the fastest way to destroy. And Beowulf just to do insane damage right away. With the Quicksilver right away and just starting hammering on the web. Just a wonderful boss. No, it's not a hard boss, actually an easy boss fight. If you know what you're doing. And sometimes the doppelganger can be close to you, really close. And I can do, oh by the way, that fire attack can actually deflect with your weapon. So, and you can run back at them. I'm using DT here just to make the operation faster. And as you can see, I failed. Now that did damage, and I can just do some damage against him. And I want to actually beat him, and I got hit there. That's a lot of damage in this game, because the damage you take in this game is unreal. Because against bosses, you take absurd damage. It's not as crazy as 4 and 5. This one, just you deal like so much damage, like the AI just like, literally, whoever created Dante Must Die on this game, really just, is out of his mind, literally, you're out of your fucking mind just making this goddamn difficulty. Literally, like, it's so fucking tough. And I really love the style of me actually talking, do a non-live commentary while I'm literally just watching myself play. It's actually a lot better and I can just speak freely without me being completely quiet. Talking for something and then just be quiet for the next like 2-3 minutes and come back talking again. I think it's a better choice when you do these marathons. When I do these marathons, it's by far the best way. Not doing commentary. Yeah, like I mentioned in my first The Link Part 3 video, if you commentate, you lose some skill. And I believe that's actually true. You lose, like, you lose 50% of your skill. So not much. You lose half your skill, basically. So it's better off to do this without any commentary. Literally, it's better off to do this. Or, no. Okay. It's better off to do this like post a commentary after the gameplay. A lot better, and you can just talk freely in the best games. Yeah, but it's your choice. It's your choice of doing things. You can just play the game and do live commentary, or you want to play, or second, or the other option, which is you want to just post a commentary later when you watch yourself play. It's up. Every YouTuber's different. Everyone's different, has different style. I like the style. Right, here we go. I'm just like trying to hit the ball and slow-mo, and look at that damage. That deals good damage. Use Quicksilver to make it. Because with Quicksilver, I remember when I mentioned in DMC 1 and DMC 2 that I think this game is difficult. But I was like, I remember Quicksilver having played this game before. I haven't touched this game since 2019 or something, or 2018 when I platinumed it. Here we go. He's down, he's dead, and he's gone. Here comes Mission 18, aka the Boss Rush mission. This mission is pretty easy to beat. But there's only one hard part that the boss is. It's this section here. And as you can see, normally to go against the king was in the middle. But I want to defeat the queen because the queen pauses death. Poses a ton of problems because she's the one that moves plates and moving plates of the other areas. And I think the chest plates on Dante Must Die are a lot more aggressive. Like it's always been, because they're so aggressive. It's just insane. Compared to like the normal numbers, look at this, you have DT, they win DT mode right away, and they have double the health, and it's very annoying. Literally one of the annoying parts of the game. Not the most annoying part of the entire game, but it's annoying doing it normally. I remember doing this for the first time normally, it was fucking painful. And Nothing Must Die, I just didn't like it. I think it's bullshit, I think it's just very cool section. Very, very cool section, I don't know why they got so freaking crazy and then made up with this. I'm sorry that my country cut out the whole time. It's just like that. So I'm just trying to check the time. I'm playing with time just to put the camera in. So Quicksilver and just beat the Queen up and then go to King and kill him. So at least the Queen is when the Queen is down, I can just at least focus on the King and just attack pretty much. As you can see, look at that. The Queen just passes. There we go, the Queen's down. Now I can go. Oh, actually, that was actually the King. So the King is down, and you have to focus on the King, by the way, on normal difficulty. I'm pretty much on all to focus on it. Alright, now this part is very easy to beat. I equip my Anion Rudra because I'm gonna fight Cerberus. The bosses you have to beat the level are Cerberus, Anion Rudra, and Beowulf. Beat these three bosses, you'll beat the level. You'll get the mirror that teleports you to the next mission. Very easy. I don't want to do the whole thing because it'll drag on forever. But there is a reward for doing all of it. You'll get a blue orb fragment. So that's how you get one of the blue orb fragments. Let's just beat all the bosses. But I'm not gonna be like a hardcore mode and just fucking go crazy, being sadistic and spend all the levels. Just play the levels that beat like needed, and that's it. Just beat all the levels. Just beat some levels immediately. As you can see, I'm using the Rudra for jumping and the triangle attack is very damaging, and you can damage all three heads. So you do tons of damage and you get electrical explosion and this level boss. Easy to beat, no issues. Gonna beat normally. I go in that corner and just do the trick, the gun cancel trick. If I do it normally. Best way to do it without a problem. So you can see it's done, and I'm gonna do it too. Now here comes the next boss, which basically is Beowulf, and I'm doing his punch at his face. His eye is basically his weak spot. Since with the slow movement, it makes it easy to hit his eye even more with DT explosion. That move is pretty damaging, as you can see. If you saw it, I got hit there. It deals damage. It's not. It's pretty much the hardest game. If Dante Must Die related, this is the hardest Dante Must Die in the entire games series. And look at that. One slap just took a lot of my health away. Look at that. That's one of the things about this game I like. If you like one hit from a goddamn boss will fucking like wreck your health bar real fast. As you can see, I'm trying to do a Okay, watch out. That move, get out the way. That's why you got to look at that move. It takes a lot of hits, even plus that volcano punch as well takes a lot of hit damage. But I have my DT on, so it makes it a little easier just to get through. And I'm trying to do double explosion just to kill him even faster. He's trying to put pillars. Trying to throw at you. Trying to sort them from off the ceiling, and you know, I just killed him. Murder this guy, and right now we're gonna fight the final one, which is basically Andy and Rudra themselves. You can see the transitions, and doing the easy method is basically stand between them and wait and just taunt them. I could have just had Cerberus with me as my weapon because it's fast and it's good, but I decided to not just do that and just go with the basically hitting themselves basically in a weird way. I'm basically hitting them with their weapon. I'm basically hitting themselves in kind of a weird funny way. I'm hitting themselves. They basically hit themselves using their weapons, so on them. It deals good damage. I like the Cerberus. Cerberus is so damaged against the red one. Red guy takes a ton of hits. It's really, and I'm definitely, as you can see, double trigger explosion helps out tremendously. It deals tons of damage. I'm just kick out of Quicksilver, and I'm trying just a trick just to completely not get fucking somersaulted by the enemies. I'm trying to go between them. I try to like to stun them or just hit Cloud with their sword so they can get stunned. But they hit themselves, they're idiots, so... That's not only like, kind of like a... fairway. Use Devil Secret Explosion. People can use Royal Guard and do a Royal Release, and that deals even more damage. That's actually a fastest way to kill them. And I thought I just ran away from that and I got hit, but it's okay. Everyone is dead and gone, and that's the end level. Level's done. Goodness, this boss level is very, very fast. Very simple level. So here we are now on the second to last level of the game, Mission 19. Which features the worst boss in the game that I think I actually might fast forward the boss because it's a piece of shit boss. Literally is a piece of shit boss battle. And I hated the boss fight. It's one of the worst bosses in this game, if not the worst boss in the game. Because he's bullshit and not because he's that hard. The reason is when you get him to 50% of his health gone, you have Virgil with you, and he's basically... It's like giving a 4-year-old a controller and never play the Devil May Cry game. It literally felt like Virgil is blind and just stupid as hell. That's the thing, is he's not helpful at all. So get your DT and your style away. So there's actually a solution. There's two ways you can do it. If you want to do it legitimately, just go in the corner and just shoot it with the Avian Ivory when these, I don't know, caterpillars come in. These worms, whatever the heck it's called. These eels. Yeah, eels. Yeah, the eels come out. Just shoot with a rocket launcher and with a clean hand and just destroy them. You get a lot of style points, a lot of DT, by the way. So you can shoot DT a lot and use it. So, and you get a lot of style points for just doing that. It's really useful. Or the other method is basically use, as soon as the second part starts, spam holy waters on him. And then you can just beat him and that's it, in the fucking fight. You can literally beat this fight with just no problem. That's why I bought so many holy water just for that boss battle. That boss fight is a goddamn nightmare of a boss. I just hate the boss. And we're just gonna fight him a little bit shortly now, and you're gonna see me how to deal with him. He's a shitty boss, and I completely dislike the boss so bad. He is... I believe, out of all the Devil May Cry games, like the worst boss, him and Nightmare 3, I believe, are the absolute worst bosses. And the second form of Dante are the three worst bosses of this game. And I believe the most annoying bosses in the entire game. Like, to be honest, like, to be like seriously honest, is one of, if not the absolute piece of shit boss fight like I have ever seen. Like, good lord, it's just stupid. Like, these three bosses are complete bullshit. Like, Nightmare 3, he's basically just a fucking, like, he's have fucking superpower mode, fucking super armor. Like, he's like fucking armored and takes like 2 times the hits as you when you fight him on normal or fight him the first time. Just fucking bullshit. You got now this fucking lava boss. Just all you gotta do is just do this all the time and just... It's just not even fun. And then you have this section here when he has his these freaking whatever these things. These fucking spears. That deal tons of damage. You're gonna see me when I fight Urizen on DMC5 with Virgil. I'm gonna use Super Dante in that fucking fight because... Super Virgil in that fight because I just hate fighting. I just hate fighting that boss. It's a fucking nightmare. It's abhorrent and it's like fucking... It's fucking retarded to the point it's just ridiculous. What the fuck? Like, what in the god's name of hell did they freaking thought with this goddamn boss? That boss is such a goddamn mess. It's literally a fucking mess of a boss at the end of the day. It's just the shittiest boss ever. Like, normally I don't skip any bosses and make a fast mode, but just for this boss, this makes an exception. This boss is just fucking so, like, retarded. Alright, now we got this Virgil 3, which is the most epic boss in the game. Alright, so basically with Virgil here, he is pretty aggressive, very, very aggressive in this as a final boss. He's very aggressive and pretty much the same as 2, but without Beowulf, basically. But he adds a lot of new shit. And he goes DT, like, a lot. Like, so many times, it's fucking retarded. I'm trying to, well, fighting him legitimately, because I can actually beat him legitimately. I got, the tools I need. Like, somewhat legit. I'm not gonna say legit 100%. As you can see, I'm trying to do Sacred Bees. It deals tons of damage with DT on, and I'm just, of course, taunting him just to get some stuff. Look at the stinger! Jesus fucking Christ! With him with DT on, it's just, look at the damage. Oh my god. That's what happens when you just be cocky and just being stupid and not be careful. Jesus Christ, look, that fucking stinger deals so much damage. It's just stupid. Alright, so we're just gonna do definitely the same thing. He's using round trip, which is bullshit. I hate his round trip. It deals stupid damage. And when DT mode, as you can see, he does don't get so cocky and just summon sword, just fucking blow him up before this supposed to say summon swords deal hellacious damage, and if you don't destroy them, well, you can see yourself game over, man. As you can see, it's just funny to see Virgil in slow-mo just fight. As you can see, I'm trying to do some small little combos, not doing too crazy insane combos to get myself in danger like that. I got judgment cut and just, well, I have super character, so I'm not that big of a deal. If I don't have a super character, I'll be fucking dead already, but oh well. At least the thing about this one is if I die on the final boss or the last level, whatever you call it, but mostly those last will always be the final boss, so you'll be fine. You'll be fine. You'll have no problem and all that shit, so yeah. As you can see, he's now going to his Helmbreaker phase. And I'm just running away and trying to jump away. As you can see, I think I just got hit, maybe not. Because I'm just too focusing on watching myself play. So, as you can see, I'm just going crazy, and Virgil's going crazy with his fucking DT mode. He regens health, by the way. Look at that stinger again! I fall for that shit again! And I was like, I'm not having it, I'm just gonna use a healing item. I was like, fucking hell, look at that. It's like, it deals so much damage, it's just ridiculous. It's just fucking stupid. It's just dumb. It's really dumb. Alright, here we go. I'm going to DT mode. I'm going to go Sliver and just try to destroy him and dealing damage against him. And here we go. Now that's where Sliver comes into play. Gun canceling him to oblivion until he get his swords away and beat his ass. Hope you guys enjoyed the Devil May Cry 3's marathon. Sorry that took so long for me to actually do them. I'm really sorry for it took so long for me to finish them. But finally, it's coming to an end, and I'm finally happy that this is actually over. So now I can do Devil May Cry 4 next. Hope in a few days I can make my first video will be uploaded maybe by the weekend. I hope. Maybe I should might start doing it on Wednesday. I'll be starting doing the video on either on Wednesday or Thursday. I'll be starting making that video, so and expect me doing the video later on. So expect that. It's gonna happen soon. And yeah, that's all I gotta say at this point. I'm just watching myself now beating Virgil. And that is the end of the marathon. The end of the, not the whole marathon as a whole, but that's the end of Devil May Cry
thing with that. I like how Virgil just wanna pull like one, like a Joker. He pulls a goddamn like one trick in his sleeves and just dies. Just a judgment cut end. So yeah. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.